Just got a text from Tom Deacon. He's arranged for Ironic to come open the radio station for us.
Why were you at the sanctuary? Ask me another one.
I think you're right to be worried.
Worried about what?
About Marla. I think she might be sick.
You're about to go international. You've got that pretty much secured, but only if you stay focused.
I think I want to keep it.
You out so early?
I just had to get some stuff.
What stuff?
Stuff before school, okay?
Look, if you want to talk to me, you can.
About what?
About whatever. It kept me awake all night, you're not telling me about that jab.
Look, it was nothing.
Look, it's the kind of stuff, if your mother was here, you'd talk to her about. I just want you to know that you can talk to me too, all right?
Thanks.
I gotta go, late as it is.
How about lunch?
Yeah.
I could probably be back about one.
One it is.
There.
Thanks.
That's a pretty big deal.
Yep, probably landed on my feet.
Nice way for Marla to say sorry, sorting out all this.
I've given her, just about. So, what did your coach say about you missing Budapest?
Oh, it'll take him a while to forgive me.
Did you tell him why?
Of course not. Catherine, if I ask you something, do you promise I won't go back to Marla? You know, when Jay came back, did they...
Did they what?
Do you think she slept with him?
It's your baby, Elliot.
She'd have told you if she did, yeah?
Yes. It's not Jay's. Do yourself a favour and get that thought out of your head.
Good luck with this.
Thanks. Tune in, yeah?
Well, yeah, Jack. Can you use your laptop, please, mate? Jack.
You're right, I was just using your laptop to do some last minute homework.
Okay.
But I've got to go and be late for school.
Laters.
So this is what you call focused?
I'm sorry I'm late, sir.
Again. I think I like getting up at 6 waiting for you to maybe show up.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, so am I. This is your last chance. Forget about this session, but if you are not at the pool bang on 4:30 for time trials, consider yourself off the team.
Wallaby.
What smoothie would you like?
Bit broke.
My treat. I recommend one without the lime. An extra shot of guava and double up on the goji berries.
I'll have boysenberry and blackcurrant.
Excellent choice.
Morning.
Cam, how are you? How was the funeral?
Yeah, good, yeah, amazing. Best funeral ever. So, you two an item now?
Yes, my friend, this is true.
Awesome. That's awesome.
I know you're going through a hard time with your grandpa's dead, so I took the liberty in bringing this in for you.
It's all about the five stages of dealing with grief. Denial, anger, bargaining, depression, and acceptance.
No thanks, no, I'm fine. Really, I'm fine.
Stage one. Textbook.
Hi. How was training?
Yeah, it was fine.
Can you grab my hairbrush? It's on the table.
We were both young when I first saw you. I closed my eyes and...
Marla, can I ask you something?
We have to tell Dad. I know that it's scary, but we have to tell him, because if we don't, Taylor will. She knows.
She knows?
Yeah, I had this appointment card for the hospital and she saw it. We'll tell him together.
He's gonna hit the roof.
Yeah, he's not gonna love it, but we'll just have to show him that we are completely together on this and that it's our decision.
Yeah, okay, for sure.
Okay. Well, I told him 1 o'clock.
1 o'clock what?
That we'd meet him for lunch at 1. You can be here then, right? We have to tell him together.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, hairbrush. Okay, what's wrong with you?
Nothing.
You haven't listened to a word I said in the last block, so either you're ignoring me, which I highly doubt, or something's wrong with you.
Look, it's Jack. I found something on his computer.
He lives alone. What do you expect?
Shut up. It wasn't that. It was some stuff about this kid that got killed, a hit and run.
So he reads the news. What's the big deal?
Look, I'm telling you, there's something weird about him.
There's something weird with everyone, Alex.
Well, think about it. He must have been at the sanctuary for a reason.
There it is.
There what is?
The sanctuary? It always leads back to Stephen.
This has got nothing to do with Stephen.
Yeah, it does. You're jealous because he's Stephen's friend and they have secrets that don't involve you.
You're wrong. That's got nothing to do with it.
Whatever. I'm going to be late for class.
Okay, so they'll arrive here.
They?
Ironic and his manager. Then we'll both take them through to the studio.
You all organised?
Just about.
But one chance to get this right. We spent a lot of money on the radio licence.
Don't worry, it'll be a complete success. You know, you should just tell her if you have a problem with them being together.
Problem? No. I'm cool.
Could you hand out some flyers for me? I want the whole school tuning in at 5 p.m. Really help?
Sure, I'll do it.
Thanks. Link?
You can start by handing these out. Just tell everyone they've never seen anything like it.
I'm fine.
Marla, you look awful. Come on, let's get you to the nurse.
No, I'm all right, honestly.
You're not all right, you just fainted.
I didn't faint, I just got a little bit lightheaded. Probably just need to eat.
You need to get checked out.
No, I can't, I've got to go.
Mr. McKinnon. Hi. Is Marla in?
No. Do you want to come in?
No.
She said she'd be back in a minute. Come in.
Eat your lunch rather than each other.
Oh, this is it, the new radio station. What do you think?
Yeah, not bad, man, not bad. Did you do it yourself?
I had a little bit of help, but yeah, pretty much.
But you guys were at Radio 1 before, though, right?
Yeah.
And what happened?
It's a long story. Sai, shouldn't I be the one asking you the question? Come through? So we're going to do a pre-record, which will then broadcast at 5 p.m. Is that cool?
Yeah, that's cool, man.
You ready?
Born ready, DJ C. And we're recording.
Ironic, welcome to the first ever broadcast of Deaconsfield FM. Thank you so much for coming in.
No problem, man. Thanks for having me.
So I hear you've been very busy, what with hanging out, making music with 90210 stars. How's that been?
Line up. Welcome to French class. As you can see, I am neither Monsieur Ellis, nor am I French. Therefore, French class has become PE. Comprende? Well, you're late, en retard.
Can't call me a retard, sir. It's offensive.
I said en retard, which you'd know if you weren't retaking the subject, is in fact French for late. Get changed, both of you. Now, who'd like to score brownie points and lead the warm-up?
Frankie will do it. She's really good at it.
What? No, I won't.
Actually, seeing as you missed PE yesterday, Francesca, I think that's a marvellous idea. Thanks, Benedict.
This is Dan McKinnon. Ruby. No, she's not back yet. What do you mean she's blacked out? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, of course I will. Okay, thanks. Elliot, what's going on with Marla?
Windmill. And hips. Everyone, hips.
Okay, this isn't Pineapple Studios, that's enough. Team captains, Frankie and Taylor. My two PE princesses, go.
Adam.
Greg.
Can't be
always me. Alex.
George.
Colin.
Natalie.
Marcus.
Joe.
Laura.
Brett.
Amanda.
Always
burns,
whose lessons always learn.
Frankie, in your own time.
Noah.
Cameron.
What do you mean she blacked out?
That's what she said.
So what, has she gone to the hospital or...?
She just left.
Why did she collapse?
Well, I don't know. You tell me. Well, come on, then tell me. First she's not talking to you, then she's all over you. Well, you can't play dumb all the time.
She's pregnant.
Dad, say something.
How long have you known?
We were careful, we really were.
How long?
A couple of weeks.
Why didn't you tell me?
Because I knew you'd act like this.
Oh, this is me being unreasonable.
Yeah.
We're keeping the baby.
Get out! Get out! You're not going through with this.
I'm 18, Dad. I can do what I want.
Don't be so stupid.
Mum was 18 when she had Stephen.
Exactly. You've known each other for what, 5 minutes? What do you know about parenting?
Oh, a hell of a lot more than you. Yeah, you're a great example, aren't you, Dad? Tony, Tina, don't you dare lecture me.
Listen to yourself, Marla.
I hate you. So there you have it, Deaconsfield, an exclusive. Ironic, thank you so much for coming in.
No problem, thanks for having me, man.
That's all we have time for now, but for loads more celebrity interviews, gossip and the hottest music around, keep it Deaconsfield FM.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate you coming in.
No problem, man. It's been really fun.
Great interview. We're going to get the tickets to the show to you next week.
Cool. Thank you.
I'll walk you out. Maybe I could get in on that ticket action too.
Bye.
What do I want on this pizza?
Anchovies.
Clearly you don't know her at all. She hates anchovies.
Actually, I love anchovies. I changed my mind. So who's going to cut the onion while I bake the base?
So look, I need to take Frankie somewhere special tonight. Where would you go?
Poetry. She loves a bit of poetry.
Really?
Those open mic nights, take her to one of those and if you want to earn extra brownie points, get her to do an impromptu performance. She might protest, but that's just because she's lacking confidence. Make her do it and she's all yours.
Cameron, you're a true friend. Thank you.
Why are you both crying?
I did.
How'd it go? Brilliant. We nailed it, and there isn't a wall left in the school that isn't plastered with the launch deeds.
Thank you so much, guys. I'm so happy with it all.
So, it went well then?
I'm telling you, she's a natural. Question, insight, exclusive, boom.
Any chance I can get a sneaky listen?
Sure, we're just about to listen back. Luke, do you want it? Where's the recording from the second mic?
Hang on.
Luke, please tell me you put on Ironic's mic, not just mine. This is a disaster! Take all the posters down! Take them down!
Close my eyes for a while. And force from the world a patient smile.
Sorry, that was awful.
What happened to sticking together? You totally left me high and dry, and then when we told him, you didn't even stand up for me.
High and dry? Are you serious? I fainted at school.
I was on my own, Marla. I didn't even want to tell him in the first place.
Oh, yeah, that's a great idea, isn't it, Elliot? Keep it to ourselves, and then one day come home and be like, oh, hi, Dad, here's a grandkid.
Shut up, Marla. Maybe he's right. Maybe we are just kids.
Don't say that.
I'm serious. What if we don't know what we're doing?
I can't do this without you.
Well, maybe you got yourself into this without me.
What's that supposed to mean?
I don't know if it's even mine, Marla. It could be Jay's.
What did you just say?
You got with him right in front of my eyes. It's not a huge leap, is it?
That's not fair.
We were safe, Marla, we were always safe.
Oh, if you doubt me that much, then maybe Dad's right.
What are you doing now?
Going home.
Thought you might want to hang out.
Why?
Don't know, just thought we had something going on.
You thought we had a thing?
Yeah, kinda.
If I want you, I'll come find you.
I'd be more mad if you weren't right.
What do you mean?
I'm not a great dad. But I do know you don't have to go through this on your own.
I fell
fell out with him.
You didn't fall out with me. We're going to get through this. Okay?
Sorry, I'm late, sir. I had to figure out my priorities, but I'm here now.
You can't even discern if you're the father. Think about it, Elliot.
Whatever it is, I've never seen her as happy as she is when she's with you.
It's your baby, Elliot.
Do yourself a favor and get that thought out of your head.
It's your baby, it's your baby, Elliot.
Ah, oh, the star of the moment. Ryan, put the radio on. It's nearly 5 o'clock.
Cameron, what the hell is your problem?
Oh, easy, Frankie.
No. Thanks to you, Noah's put me up to perform a modern interpretive dance inspired by Chaucer at the Poetry Breathes night because he said that you told him that that's what I was into. Think it's funny, do you?
Yeah, I do.
Why have you got to make me look like an idiot on my date?
Maybe because you've been making me look like an idiot all day.
What? How?
You've been flirting with him and shoving it right in my face.
Cameron, you set me up with him. What did you expect?
Didn't think you'd go for him.
Well, I did. So, well done you.
I've got to stop this.
You're crazy. Listen.
Look, I couldn't care less, but as soon as you get a boyfriend, you just dump me as your friend.
They just totally saved your bacon.
I dumped you. You haven't spoke to me in ages.
My grandpa died.
Cam, that's just mean. I was there for you, and you're using that as an excuse not to see me or speak to me after.
After what?
After I had sex with you, that's what.
She doesn't want to see you.
Mala, I was wrong.
She doesn't want to see you.
Please, Mala, come on. I didn't mean it. I feel so stupid now. I didn't mean it, I swear to you.
Well, then why do you say it then?
Because I'm scared. I've never been so terrified and happy before in my whole life. I just said the wrong thing. Please, Marla, just let me in.
It's up to you, Marla. Do you want him in?
Walk a mile in my shoes. Walk a mile in my shoes.
Walk a mile in my shoes.
Walk a mile in my shoes.